Ghana was trying to recover from the disruptions caused by the COVID-19 pandemic this year. In 2021, the country oversubscribed its 3 billion euro bonds and was regarded as part of the emerging markets economies. But a year later, the country quickly drifted into debt distress. The economy tumbled when its dollar bonds crashed on international markets. It came after ratings agencies, Fitch and Moody's, downgraded Ghana's credit ratings, sparking low confidence about the country's economic growth among investors.
Our inability to access the international capital markets meant that for the first time in our administration, we did not have the foreign debt foreign currency to complement our foreign exchange earnings. We have had to make strenuous efforts to meet our import bill, which exceeds $10 billion annually. Considering our low foreign earnings, it has been difficult to meet our import requirements, including crude oil and petroleum products, of about $400 million a month.
The Russia-Ukraine conflict also took its toll on Ghana's economy when supply chains were cut. It led to skyrocketing inflation due to hikes in fuel prices, the cost of food, and almost everything. Inflation rose to more than 50% in November. Ghana is now seeking a $3 billion support package from the IMF to help its economy recover.
The government and the IMF agreed on program objectives, a preliminary fiscal adjustment path, debt strategy, and financing required for the program to be in line with the government's post-COVID-19 program for economic growth. The PCPEC is government's blueprint to restore macroeconomic stability, promote debt sustainability, sustain economic recovery, and support structural reforms.
Part of the program includes restructuring its domestic debts, which would see investors lose their interest payments and extend the maturity of their bonds. But labor unions are resisting it and have urged the government not to include their pension funds in the domestic debt restructuring program.
If we implement this budget in its current form and shape, and if we do not deal with the debt question that is hanging on our neck in a way that is decisive, in a way that protects the economy, I see a much more difficult year in 2023 than in 2022. We are starting the year without Forex. Normally, we generate more revenue in December because that's where the activity is. This December, people didn't get the Forex to import.
Meanwhile, the government has suspended payments on its external debts. It includes Eurobonds, bilateral and commercial loans.
2022 has been a tough year for Ghana, and it may be a long road ahead for the country's economy to bounce back. But the government hopes once the IMF $3 billion loan hits its account next year, things may begin to improve. Nabil Ahmed, Rufai, CGTN, Accra, Ghana.